Job about 3 years now. Seen a lot of mower abuse in a short amount of time. You know, I became a lawnmower detective to serve my community, make it a better place.
Hey, knock it off. No skateboarding.
Kind of nice going to bed at night knowing that you made a difference in your community, you know. Everyone thinks it's all glitz and glamour, but you know, it's more than that. It's a lot of hard work, too. Oh, what's this? We're getting a call.
We're getting reports of a stolen Dixie chopper. Man has a blue flannel that's hardly covering him and a blonde mullet.
Wearing a blue flannel that's hardly covering him. All right.
Look, there he is right there. Hey! Hey!
What seems to be the problem, Ossifer?
Whose lawnmower is this?
This is my mower.
All right, bud. Let me see your proof of purchase or warranty card.
I left it at home.
Oh, yeah? Well, this mower just happened to be reported stolen.
This is my mower.
So I take it this stuff here is not yours either, huh? Move that foot. Oh, look what we got here. Oh, what's that, high nitrogen? Is that what that is? That's that real potent stuff. Yeah, plants love that stuff. Oh, yeah.
That ain't mine.
No, that ain't yours. Well, you just said this was your mower, and I just found it on your mower. So, you got any warrants or anything, bud?
All right, I'm not gonna lie to you. I just got this back from the repair shop. They must have gave me the wrong one.
Oh, what a coincidence. Just got it back. Ah, how convenient. Well, guess what? The model tag matches the one on the one that's stolen. Yeah, true story. What's with the grass samples here? High nitrogen stuff? What's this, huh? What's this stuff here?
Well, I don't know.
I've been seeing a lot of this stuff around. It's illegal, you can't have this. What's this, Kentucky bluegrass fescue? Yeah, the high nitrogen stuff, not gonna fly in this town, all right? What's going on here, huh? You wanna start talking, bud?
That's not mine.
I'm just gonna test it, find out what it is. So work with me, I'll work with you.
That ain't mine.
Well, all right, bud. Since you don't want to work with me, I'm just going to do a nitrogen test on these soil samples and see how much nitrogen's in there. So, hang tight. See, a lot of the time, these guys on the streets, they like to up the nitrogen levels in the soil for the grass to make it better, more potent, make it grow thicker, and that's illegal. You can't do that. Hey, hey, oh! We got a runner. We got a runner. All right, send back up.
Pterodactyl here. Today's how-to video is going to be on a Kawasaki engine. And the Kawasaki engine just happens to be on this here Scrub Cadet. But this is a problem that we've seen on a lot of these Kawasakis. Now they put them on Scrub Cadets, they put them on X-Marks, they put them on a bunch of different mowers. Now how do you know that you got a stuck choke? That's the thing. So if your mower, say you start your mower and it's running real crappy. So we'll show you what a stuck choke does. Oh, got to push down the pedal. So the first thing I'm going to have to do is remove the hood so I can show you a little better that stuck choke and what we're going to do to fix it. So on this scrub cadet, you gotta take the headlights out. Because they didn't want to put a... They didn't want to put a connector here so you can disconnect the headlights. Isn't that just nice? Look at that. What a quality machine. I can't even get the bulbs out. The bulbs won't even come out. Look at that. What a piece of garbage this thing is. All right, we'll just have to pull the wires off the sockets. They don't want, there we go. And release this tab here. Now we can get the hood off. Got a rocket. Get it right in that sweet spot. There we go. Alright. So look right here. This is the choke lever. I'm gonna pull on the choke cable. Nope, that's the PTO switch. See how that comes up and lifts that lever. That lever, when you take the choke off, is supposed to go back down. It's got a little spring on it to help it. But it's stuck. Now let me fire up the tractor and you'll hear. It's a plastic choke shaft. I'll make everything out of plastic. So like I said, this Kawasaki engine's on a bunch of different mowers and it's got that shaft. So that's something you have to check if you got one that's running crappy. So we're gonna need a 10 millimeter socket because we're gonna have to take this off and take this bracket and get it out of the way so we can remove all this. And as you can tell, this lawnmower has been really, really well taken care of. Now I know what you're saying. I can hear you.
Maybe you just gotta spray some cleaner on there and clean it. That's all you need. You just need to spray that with some cleaner and clean that up.
Yeah, well, we've tried that and they still stick. Here, I'll get some cleaner. Get some carbon. Carbon choke cleaner. Oh, that's working good. Look at that. That's the ticket. No, it doesn't work. I've done that before. And you know what? It just comes back. Because it sticks again. So we're going to need to remove this little intake horn here, or elbow. So 10 millimeter deep well socket. Take those two nuts off. And then lose them. And then we got to remove this screw. Sometimes it's a screw, sometimes it's a 10 millimeter bolt. And then just lay this out of the way. And then here, while we're at it, get some of that nastiness out of there. Look at that. I'll blow that out later. And then let's, with a pair of needle nose, take that hose off. And we got our intake crankcase breather hose here, which has got a clamp on it. We need to remove that. And then we could take this off. And there's your dinner. Of course, the gasket broke, but it's intact, so I'm just going to leave it alone. Because I don't have another gasket. I'll just put a little sealer on there when I put it back together. Now, see, still sticking. So with a pair of needle nose again, grab this choke plate and pull it out. Now we can remove this choke shaft. Now there's a spring here that we're going to have to put that tension on it again when we go to reinstall. See how tight that is? See how tight it fits? So let's take off the spring and that little washer. It's got a fiber washer and a metal washer. So let's take all that off and not lose it. Now we need to get some sandpaper and sand this down. That's the only way to fix it, or buy a new one. But then you gotta look up the part, you gotta order the part, get some 150 grit sandpaper, and just sand it down, because it somehow it swelled up. And then we'll take some carb spray, kind of spray it off a little bit, get any of that dust off. We'll spray a little in there, and then we'll try it and see if we have to sand it some more. That's moving pretty free now. I'm going to sand it a little more. So still a little tight. A little tight spot. Right around here. Let me get a Q-tip too. Hold on. And spray a little carb spray. Get that Q-tip wet. It was pretty clean just from spraying it. Dry it off with the dry, the other end of the Q-tip. This is still good. I'll probably clean my ears with this later. Now we'll try it. Oh yeah. Yeah, nice and free. All right, so now let's reinstall the spring and the washer. There's the spring, the washer, and a little dust seal. So it's going to fit down. There's that right there, which is going to go up against that because we got to put preload on this. So we want this end of the spring to go underneath this here. See how that little spot there is sticking out like a pin? We want to get it under there. Now we've got this, we're holding it like this. There's our slot. And when I pulled it out, I laid it down flat. Just like that. And you just push it in until it clicks. See? Now it's working like it's supposed to. Not sticking anymore. See how simple that is? And you're probably pulling your hair out wondering, why is this thing running like crap? Running like chokes on. Yeah, because the choke is on. All right, let me clean up this part before I reinstall it. And I'm gonna put a real light coat of gasket sealer on there, because I don't have another gasket. I'd have to order it. So this part, I'm just going to wash it in the sink with some soapy water. Mainly just dirt stuck to it.
instead of using, you know, carb spray. Plus, if you're doing this at home, you're like,
I got soap and water. I won't be able to take a bath now because I used it all. To clean that elbow, now I don't have no soap and water to take a bath with.
A lot of dirt got past that air cleaner. That's why you gotta maintain your equipment. Spend thousands of dollars of hard-earned money on something and then just trash it. I don't get that.
All right, nice and clean. Dry it off. Put some sealer on there and
put it back together. So I'm just gonna put a real thin layer. You don't wanna go crazy with this stuff. You don't need a lot. We just want it to seal. And since I left the torn part still on there, it'll match back up with it. Now we sell this black silicone in our online store. So if you wanna get some, you can get the same black silicone that Terrell uses and impress all your friends and family.
I'm using the same silicone that Terrell uses.
I need to wipe this. Now we'll stick this back on. Like so. Put that screw in there. See this? This engine's got a plastic manifold on it. That's why they're using this plastic screw. So I worked on one of these. Remember the Kamisaki video we did a few weeks ago? That had a metal intake manifold. Remember the botched job? Same engine. 600V. This is a FR. I think that was a FS. Let me get that clamp back on there. Yeah, because that one had a 10 millimeter headed bolt there because it was a metal manifold. Put our little pollution control hose back on. All right, now I'm gonna pull on the choke, Mr. Cameraman, watch. Now that'll go up and down like it's supposed to. See? Now it's working. There's your dinner. Now all we have to do is the rest of the service on this tractor. Look at this thing. I'd be embarrassed to bring this to a shop to get fixed. Look at that. I think they got their money's worth out of that filter. Woo, boy. I know I got one of these too. And then put the hood back on. Well, we'll leave it off because we gotta service this thing now. So, that's all there is to fixing that sticky choke lever. That didn't take long, did it? That was pretty simple. You can do that yourself. That's why you're watching these videos. It's a how-to channel. And I'm showing you how to. You just gotta figure out what how to do. Doodly doodly do. So, subscribe to this YouTube channel, Terrell Fixes All. I'm Terrell, the choke shaft fixer, or the choke shaft sander, whatever you wanna call me. Follow me with your sticky choke shafts on Facebook and Instagram. Go to our web store, buy some of the products that we got there, like that silicone. So maybe you want to get a shirt, like this shirt, and a spark plug necklace, and some silicone. And you can go around like this and seal up some gaskets. Sound like a good idea? And as always, there's your dinner. Woo! Yeah! Sticky choke shaft, we see it all the time.
I lost sight of the subject. He's somewhere in this yard here. So send back up when you can. I'm gonna keep investigating, looking for him. He's around here somewhere. All right, I hear something coming from over here in the east end of the yard. I'm gonna go investigate. Send back up. Put your hands up! Come out! Freeze! Hands in the air! Oh, it's you!
Oh, hey, detective. They sent me as your backup. So I got bored and I just started looking through these old parts.
Yeah, well, keep it down. He's around here somewhere. False alarm, it was just Detective Dactyl. We're gonna keep searching the yard. All right, follow me. What are you doing? Put that stuff down. You can't take that stuff. Leave it here. Put it down. What are you doing? Leave it.
A lot of times when we're in pursuit of a suspect, we come across a lot of good stuff.
Long way, detectives. Give yourself up. I got a $25 gift card to Ratley's I want to use. I'm getting hungry. Where is he at? Freeze! He's in the air! Get up! Lay down! Get up! Lay down! Get up! Lay down!
Which one is it?
Roll over! All right, speak! Speak! Give me paw! Give me the other paw! All right, good dog. You ain't got nothing on you that's gonna stick or poke me, do you, bud?
No. I got a number two pencil in my back pocket. It's pretty sharp.
Oh, he ain't lying. Yeah, that is pretty sharp. All right, hold on to that, detective. You ain't got nothing else, do you? Another job well done.
High five!
High five, yeah! Woo! Trying to take off? All right, I'm gonna test these soil samples for high nitrogen. So I'm gonna stick this Q-tip in there, and if it turns blue, then that's a positive. I gotta wait a few minutes on that. All right, on a count of three, pull yours out, detective. One, two, three. Oh yeah, yep, you can see it's blue. Yep, that's a positive. Yeah, that's high nitrogen. That's illegal. You can't have that.
Oh, yeah, there's the blue right there.
Yeah.
Hey, think maybe I can get a couple of them Q-tips to clean my ears?
That's not what they're for, detective.
I gotta clean my ears.